Now we are discussing about specific heat capacity. For example, I am taking one metal or water or liquid or anything in a gas or so. Okay, first we are discussing about solids and liquids, not gases. For example, I am taking one material. I am taking one body. Mass of the body I am taking as M. So, I want to raise its temperature. 1 degree centigrade or 2 degree centigrade. Constant temperature it is. I want to raise its temperature delta T. 1 gram mass you take, 2 gram mass you take, similarly 3 gram mass you take. For increasing 1 degree centigrade, 102 or in constant temperature raising, in that case, compared to 1 gram, 2 gram, for 3 gram, you must give more amount of heat. So, heat, supplied heat is proportional to mass of the body. Mass of the body. For example, I am taking 1 kilogram body or 1 gram body, raising 1 degree centigrade. In that case, how much heat required? Similarly, same body, same material taking. But in that second case, I am taking increasing 10 degree. Compared to 1 degree, 10 degree, you must give more heat. Similarly, compared to 10 degree, 20 degree is raising, again more heat. So, temperature raising more means you must supply more heat. So, again, heat is proportional to raise in temperature. What is the M? Mass of the body. M is the mass of the body. And what is the delta T? Rise in temperature. This is rise in temperature. So, by combining these two, I am writing as Q is proportional to M into delta theta. Delta theta means rise in temperature. So, when I am eliminating this proportional, I am writing one proportional constant. That we are taking as S. So, S into M into delta T. S or in some books they write C also. This is called specific heat capacity. This is called specific heat capacity. Specific heat capacity of the body. Of the body means that body made by definitely some material. So that goes to material. So what about S? S equal to Q by M into delta theta. So that is the formula for specific heat capacity. Okay, now we go to SI units. What are the SI units? SI units. Energy, joule. Mass, kilogram. Raise and temperature. Kelvin, you are taking general. Similarly, you go to CGS system. CGS units. Energy, heat energy, calories. This is gram and degree centigrade. I had already told raising temperature, Kelvin or degree centigrade, both were considering in the same value. Okay, that is about specific heat capacity. Now you go to definition. What is the definition of the specific heat capacity? This is one, at that time S equal to Q. So that is the definition to specific heat capacity. So what is the one here? For example, M equal to 1 gram and delta T equal to 1 degree centigrade. At that time S equal to what? Q by 1 into 1. So S equal to Q. This belongs to CGS. If you go to SI, this is 1 kilogram. This is CGS units. If you go to SI system, if you go to SI units, M equal to 1 kilogram. Raising temperature 1 Kelvin. Substitute S equal to Q by 1 into 1. So S equal to Q. In the CGS system, Q is in the calories. In the SI system, Q is in the joules. What is the relation between calorie and joule? 1 calorie equal to 4.182 joules. 1 calorie equal to 1 calorie equal to 4.2 approximately joules. That is the relation between energy. Now what is the definition? Unit mass of the body raising unit degree, 1 degree. In that case, how much heat you have supplied? That heat only called, that magnitude of heat only called specific heat capacity. So by taking unit mass, now definition. What is the definition to specific heat capacity? By taking unit mass of a body, by taking unit mass of a body, raising its temperature, raising its temperature by one unit, depends upon if it may be degree centigrade or may be Kelvin. By taking unit mass of a body, raising its temperature by one unit, required heat for that, required heat is called specific heat capacity of that material. Specific heat capacity of that material, body made by material, so that belongs to specific heat. For example, one body having more specific heat, what is its meaning? For raise 1 degree centigrade, you must give more heat. One body having less specific heat capacity, what is its meaning? For raising 1 degree centigrade, small amount of heat you give, it raises. So, that is its meaning of specific heat capacity. So, number of live examples also we are understanding in the nature. For example, in the refrigerator, by keeping watermelon and another things, after removing the watermelon, if you cutting also, it is very cool. Why? Due to specific heat capacity. In that, what is there? Water is there. Water having more specific heat capacity. Specific heat of water is 1 calorie per gram degree centigrade. Otherwise, in the SI system, you convert 1 calorie equal to 4.2 joules. Again, gram converting into kilograms. Again, degree centigrade is same only. Convert once. Specific heat of water is 1 calorie gram per degree centigrade. That I am converting into joules. How converting? 1 calorie equal to 4.2. Once you see the conversion, how we are converting? So here, what I am doing? 1 calorie per gram degree centigrade. Converting. 1 calorie equal to how many joules? 4.2. In the calorie place, joules. Gram I am converting into kilograms. At that time, what we are adding? 10 power minus 3. Kilograms. Degree centigrade or Kelvin, both are same only. Because both are 100 degrees. Raising temperature, remember, not temperature. Raising temperature, same. So, degree centigrade, Kelvin, both are same one. Now, what we are adding here? 4.2. 10 power minus 3. Here comes 10 power 3. Joule per kilogram Kelvin. So, that is the process of conversion. So, what is the specific heat of water? 1 calorie gram per degree centigrade. Otherwise, 4.2 into 10 power 3 joule per kilogram Kelvin. So, that is the process of conversion. So, that is about specific heat capacity.